What's up, guys? Hope you're doing well and ready for this new video. It's all about review funnels, how to make them, what they are, why they're important, and all that jazz. So we'll start out by reviewing what a review funnel is, why it's important, and then I will give you a step-by-step tutorial on how to make one in less than 10 minutes using Involve Me. So let's get into it. You might have heard of sales funnels. If you haven't, definitely check out my last video on funnels versus flywheels. You can click over here to check it out, or it will also be linked in the description. But a review funnel is a wonder only a select few are familiar with. Let me open the ancient gates to, no. Let me unveil the secret of, let me just show you how a funnel works. Review funnel, to be specific. They're really cool and they save you a lot of time. So what is a review funnel? A review funnel is basically a really smart survey. It does all the work for you. It can identify happy customers as well as unhappy customers and place them in separate buckets. Trust me, it's for the best. Once in these buckets, you can send people to different places. Happy customers can get an incentive to leave a review somewhere public like Trustpilot, Amazon, or G2 Crowds, or whatever floats your goat. Unhappy customers can still leave their feedback, but you keep it to yourself. You keep it internal. Conceal, don't feel, don't let them know. And now they know. You and only you can see where things went wrong and then use it to improve your business. Sounds genius. Now, how do we set it up? I'm going to build a whole review funnel from start to finish. I am aiming to build this in less than 10 minutes, so if the video is longer than that, then I have failed. Thoughts and prayers go out for editing Bobby. So step number one is grab a free survey template. Did I mention this is free? Because it is. So I'm going to head over to Involve Me and pick one of their templates from their template gallery. I'm going to be using the promoter feedback survey. I'm gonna click preview just to see how it looks, and then I'm gonna click on use template at the top right corner of my screen. I will just click on start editing in the project type because it automatically selects which one is best for that template. And then step number two is to customize the design. You can customize a bunch of things in here. You can change the font. You can even add your own custom font by clicking on add custom fonts. It will take you to a separate screen and here you can just upload your font. You can even change the color and the style of the entire design. So for the content card, I'm going to make it blue. And for the background, I'm going to make it yellow. And I'm also going to change the highlights to white as well as the text to white. And there we have it. You can also change the roundness of the corners if you would like. And you can also make the content card more transparent or more visible. I can even add my own logo. The way you do that is by simply dragging and dropping the image content element in here and then grabbing your font and dragging and dropping that into the upload tab, and then you can make the image a bit smaller so it looks nice, and then you just save and close and you have your logo. Step number three is to customize the functionality. Once I'm happy with the design, I can move on to setting up where everything goes. So I'm asking two questions in my review funnel. Fun fact, the more questions you ask, the less time people will spend answering each question. So if you want in-depth, honest answers, then ask fewer questions. Back to my questions. My second question is an open-ended question, which means that people can type anything they like in the box. This is something I cannot automate because everyone is going to write something different. However, the first question has selectable answers, which means that each person has to select at least one of these answers. This means that I can connect each answer to a different outcome. All I have to do is click on the question itself and then scroll down to answers. Answers 0 to 6 are connected to the detractor page. These are people who most likely don't have anything good to write about you. You don't want to ask them for a review on a public platform, but you do want to know about their experience. That is what the open question is for. You capture the feedback, but on your own internal platform where only you and your team can see it. Answers 7 and 8 are connected to the passive page. These people had a good time but aren't super enthusiastic with you. They would give you a 4-star review, not a 5-star review. And we only accept 5-star reviews here because trust me, your competitors are doing the same. I guarantee they have a system like this in place. Every major company has a automated review generation. Anyways, 7 and 8 are happy peeps. Keep sending them your newsletter, but don't ask them to review your product publicly. Answers 9 and 10 are connected to the promoter page. These are your biggest fans. These are the people who are waiting for a new product with their credit cards. They will promote your business for you. They will turn your funnel into a flywheel. Seriously, watch my funnel versus flywheel video. These are the people who will give you 5-star reviews. Once you've connected each answer to the right outcome, let's have a look at the outcome pages. Detractors and passives get a quick thank you note, and that's about it. Promoters, however, will get an incentive to leave a review on a public platform of your choice. This leave a review button is here for you to link Trustpilot, Amazon, or G2 Crowd, or whatever platform that you are focusing on. And step number 3 is to preview and test your review funnel. To make sure your funnel is working, fill it in a few times yourself. If something's not connected right, you want to know about it before your customers do. Click Design Preview to check out how the design looks on desktop and mobile. And click Try It at the top of your screen to actually take your own survey. Try It mode will show your survey the same way your customers will see it. Once you've tested your survey and it's ready, just hit on Publish at the bottom of your screen. You'll get a chance to tweak your URL, set up automated emails, social share text and image, and add tracking on Facebook and Google. Don't worry, you can always come back to this page later and change the settings even if your survey is live. And step number 5 is to share it with the world. Hitting publish one last time will make your survey go live. Yay! You'll get a link, a short link, an embed code, and even a QR code. If you've never embedded anything onto your website, this is the perfect thing to start with. See how these are 2 separate places? That's so I can't mess up the code. I can make the embed narrow, or I can make it cover the whole screen. That's up to you. And that's how simple it is. We even have a discount code for you where you can get 2 months for free after creating an account with InvolveMe. So make sure to use it and try this out. I really hope this video helped you in understanding what review funnels are and how you can easily set it up by yourself. If you did like this video, please make sure to give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell so you're notified every time we post a new video. And thanks for watching. Bye. Let it go. Let it go. Can't hold it back anymore. Let it go. Let it go. Okay, I need to stop.